Hello guys, my name is Raghav and in this video, I'm going to explain to you exactly what is the difference between a forward proxy and a reverse proxy. I will also explain why we use these things, when to use a forward proxy versus when to use a reverse proxy, and what are the best examples of each of these. Let's get started. First, let's talk about forward proxy. So when you hear someone in your office say proxy server, it usually refers to the forward proxy. A forward proxy is a server that sits in front of a client machine that wants to access the internet. For example, your work computer is a client machine and it needs to make requests to the internet and get back some data. So, in more technical terms, a forward proxy is a server which sits in front of a client or multiple clients in a local network and captures all the outgoing network traffic from these clients. Then, it forwards this traffic to the internet and to the intended destination. The client's traffic doesn't directly go to the destination. It goes via the server. So a forward proxy acts as a gateway that connects the clients or a local network to a wider network such as the internet. So if in your laptop you enter google.com, your laptop sends a request to this proxy. This proxy then forwards this request to the Google servers. And then once a response comes back, this response gets returned back to your proxy. And then this proxy returns the response back to your laptop. Now, that is the concept, but why should we have a middleman like this? Why should your organization go through extra trouble and spend more money to install a gateway in between? The answer is improved security and privacy. Because when your computer is sending the request via the proxy, and when finally Google servers receive the request, they don't see that the request is coming from your IP address. They see that the request is coming from the proxy's IP address, 172.16.35.12. This is because when your network packets are going via this proxy, the proxy will replace your IP address with its own IP address. This way, your IP address remains hidden and therefore provides you better security and privacy. And this same proxy also allows your organization to monitor and filter out any malicious network packets. Your organization can easily configure this proxy to block or alert on any malicious network packets that are being exchanged, whether outgoing or incoming. And not just malicious packets. If let's say some websites are blacklisted or some websites are just not allowed in your company, for example, facebook.com, right? They can also do that kind of configuration in the forward proxy. And then they can make sure that certain things such as internal portals of the company are only allowed when your network traffic is going via this proxy. So, a forward proxy protects the client, the one sending the request. When would you use it? Usually in a corporate environment. Every org has plenty of devices on their network, like workstations, phones, etc. They want to provide secure access to their internal network services and secure the network from malicious traffic coming from the internet. You could also use a forward proxy for your home network. Some examples of forward proxies are Apache Traffic Server, FireEye, all sorts of VPN software that you have, like NordVPN or anything, right? All of these are examples of forward proxies. VPN is also a forward proxy. And maybe you could say that it's a special case because in addition to being a forward proxy, it also provides some more benefits, better security and privacy, because it has features like end-to-end encryption of data, which is not, strictly speaking, not a forward proxy's feature, but yeah, VPNs provide that. Great. Let's move to reverse proxy. A reverse proxy is a server that sits in front of the web servers and receives all the requests from all the clients coming via the internet. It then forwards these requests to the actual web servers, who will then actually process the requests and return back some response. The proxy will then send back the response to the client. The reverse proxy protects the servers, the ones receiving the requests. It hides their IP addresses because the client will only see the reverse proxy's public IP address. So the client will think that I am sending requests to this server. So when you send a request to google.com, right, this request will travel via the internet and land on the reverse proxy servers of Google. Then that request will get forwarded to one of the internal web servers of Google, which will actually process your search request and then return back some response. And once again, a reverse proxy server can also provide features like monitoring and filtering out network packets in order to protect the web servers from receiving any malicious data. So reverse proxy can, for example, also protect web servers from a denial of service attack. And not only this, it can also provide additional features like load balancing, which will distribute the requests amongst all the servers that are available. And this way, this improves the reliability and performance of the entire web application. So if you are running any kind of web service on the internet, you will most likely need to use a reverse proxy. Nginx, HAProxy, Cloudflare, AWS, Elastic Load Balancer, these are all examples of a reverse proxy that sits in front of your web servers, your actual web servers, to receive all the requests from the internet. If you're a software engineer or a DevOps engineer, mostly you will be working with a reverse proxy. But if, for example, you're in the IT team of an organization, then you will mostly be working with a forward proxy, making sure that it works well for the entire corporate network. But no matter who you are definitely a user of both these things on a daily basis. If you're a corporate employee, probably you're using a corporate VPN, so you're using a forward proxy. If you're making requests to any of the websites like google.com or Instagram or anything, right, you are already using a reverse proxy as well. I hope you enjoyed learning with me. Don't forget to share this video with your friends and let me know if you have more ideas about what you want to learn. I make a lot of content about how to solve practical problems in DevOps and software engineering. So drop your suggestions in the comments below. See you next time.